Today we learn spermatogenesis. It is a topic under Core 12, that is of Development Biology in Semester 5, and I am covering here the portion of BBMKU particularly. So let's see spermatogenesis. I am giving you the BSc notes. So the first one is, first point is, the male contains primordial germ cells which develop into the embryo and come to inhabit the differentiating male gonad, that is testis. These primordial germ cells also are intimately associated with accessory cells known as Sertoli cells in mammals. Germ cells and their associated accessory cells line the perimeter of connective tissue tubes called seminiferous tubules. Between the tubules, there is a vascularized connective tissue containing supporting cells. Then what is spermatogenesis? So spermatogenesis is the development pathway from germ cells to begins at puberty and occurs between the Sertoli cells. Let's see a proliferative phase where stem cells spermatogonia increase by mitosis, a meiotic phase involving the two divisions that create the haploid state, a post-meiotic shaping phase called spermiogenesis, during which the round cells, spermatids, eject most of their cytoplasm and become the streamlined sperm. A proliferative phase begins when the mammalian primary germinal cells, jisko short mein hum PGCs bhi keh sakte hain, arrive at the genital ridge of a male embryo. Here they are called gonocytes and become incorporated in the sex cords that will become the seminiferous tubules. The gonocytes become undifferentiated spermatogonia residing near the basal end of the tubular cells. These are true stem cells in that they can re-establish spermatogenesis when transferred into mice whose sperm production was eliminated by toxic chemicals. Spermatogonia take up residence in stem cells niches at the junction of Sertoli cells, the epithelium of the seminiferous tubules, the interstitial testosterone-producing Leydig cells and the testicular blood vessels. Adhesion molecules join the spermatogonia directly to the Sertoli cells, which nourish the developing sperm. The mitotic proliferation of these stem cells amplifies these small population into a population differentiating spermatogonia type A spermatogonia that can generate more than 1000 sperm per second in adult human males. As the spermatogonia divide, they remain attached to each other by cytoplasmic bridges. These bridges are fragile, and when one cell splits from the others, it can become an undifferentiated spermatogonia again. The meiotic phase of spermatogenesis during puberty is regulated by several factors. So let's see the factors. The first one is glial cell line derived neurotrophic factor, jisko short form mein GDNF keh sakte hain. A paracrine factor is made by Sertoli cells and by the myoid cells that surround the tubules and give them strength and elasticity. GDNF helps keep the spermatogonia dividing as stem cells. At puberty, retinoic acid levels activate the STRA8 transcription factor, and levels of BMP8B paracrine factor reach a critical concentration. BMP8B is thought to instruct the spermatogonia to produce receptors that enable them to respond to proteins such as stem cell factor SCF. Indeed, mice lacking BMP8B do not initiate spermatogenesis at puberty. The transition between mitotically dividing spermatogonia and the spermatocytes that initiate meiosis appears to be mediated by the opposing influences of GDNF and SCF, both of which are secreted by the Sertoli cells. SCF promotes the transition to spermatogenesis, while GDNF promotes the division of spermatogonial stem cells. The second one is the meiotic phase haploid spermatids. Spermatogonia with high level of STRA8 and responding to SCF divide to become type B spermatogonia. Type B spermatogonia are the precursor of the spermatocyte and are the last cells of the line that undergo mitosis. They divide once to generate the primary spermatocyte, the cells that enter meiosis. Each primary spermatocyte undergoes the first meiotic division to yield a pair of secondary spermatocytes which complete the second division of meiosis. The haploid cells thus formed are called spermatids, and they are still connected to one another through their cytoplasmic bridges. The spermatids that are connected in this manner have haploid nuclei but are functionally diploid. Since a gene product made in one cell can readily diffuse into the cytoplasm of its neighbors. During the divisions from undifferentiated spermatogonia to spermatids, the cells move farther away from the basal lamina of the seminiferous tubule and closer to its lumen. As the spermatids move towards border of the lumen, they lose their cytoplasmic connection and differentiate into spermatozoa. In human, the progression from spermatogonial stem cells to mature spermatozoa takes 65 days. The third one, spermiogenesis, the differentiation of sperm. The mammalian haploid spermatid is a round, unflagellated cell that looks nothing but like a mature vertebrate sperm. The next step is sperm maturation. Then is spermiogenesis, spermateliosis, the differentiation of sperm cells. Spermiogenesis prepares the sperm for the functions of motility and interaction. The first step is the construction of acrosomal vesicle from the Golgi apparatus. The acrosome forms a cap that covers the sperm nucleus. As the acrosomal cap is formed, the nucleus rotates so that the cap faces the basal lamina of the seminiferous tubules. This rotation is necessary because the flagellum, which is beginning to form from the centriole on the other side of nucleus, will extend into the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. During the last stage of spermiogenesis, the nucleus flattens and condenses. The remaining cytoplasm, the residual body or cytoplasmic droplet, is jettisoned. The mitochondria form a ring around the base of the flagellum. The histones of the spermatogonia are often replaced by sperm-specific histone variants and widespread nucleosome. Widespread nucleosome dissociation takes place. This remodeling of nucleosome might also be point at which the PGC's pattern of methylation is removed and the male genome-specific pattern of the methylation is established on the sperm DNA. PGCs is primary germinal cells. As spermiogenesis ends, the histones of the haploid nucleus are eventually replaced by protamins. This replacement results in the complete shutdown of transcription in the nucleus and facilitates the nucleus assuming an almost crystalline structure. The resulting sperm then enter the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. Unexpectedly, the sperm continue to develop after they leave the testis. When being transported from the testis, sperm reside in the epididymis. During this residence, the epididymal cells release exosomes that fuse with the sperm. These exosomes have been shown to contain small ncRNAs and other factors that can activate and repress certain genes, and the sperm will bring these agents into the egg. The sperm still is not fully mature, even when it exits the urethra. The final differentiation of the sperm occurs in the reproductive tract of the female. Secretions from the oviduct will change the sperm cell membrane so that it can fuse with the membrane of the egg cell. Thus, the full differentiation of the sperm takes place in two different organisms. In the mouse, development from stem cells to spermatozoa takes 34.5 days, the spermatogonial stages last 8 days, meiosis lasts 13 days, and spermiogenesis takes another 13.5 days. Human sperm development takes nearly twice as long. Each day, some 100 million sperm are made in each human testicle, and each ejaculation releases 200 million sperm. unused sperm are either reabsorbed or passed out of the body in urine. During his lifetime, a human male can produce 10 to the power 12 to 10 to the power 13 sperm. This means about millions of sperms are released by the human male body.